brings us to our lab connecting to MinIO. As we did in the last session, I'm going to go ahead and let those of you who want to try it on your own pause right here. And anybody who would like to eventually or just stay tuned and watch the lab walkthrough, by all means, let the video continue to run. This lab is presuming that you've got your MinIO environment up and running. You've got a dev bucket available and you've got a user, dev password that we've already set up in the previous lab. If you had to shut down your environment, remember that we named your container MinIO. You ought to be able to get that back up and running with just a simple Docker start MinIO and should come right back to life for you with all the data still intact. So what we're going to do here is use MinIO's Python library to connect to a MinIO server. So first step, you're going to open up your terminal window and you need to run the command pip3 install MinIO. Now, those of you who have already been working with it, like myself, this may already be done for you, but this is the step you're going to want to take. Now, there we go. We've already got this installed. I do have some issues with my homebrew setup, but don't worry too much about that. I have my MinIO installed, I have Certify, and I have URL Live. Those are the three key libraries that get installed when you are working with MinIO. The Certify library, by the way, is no longer functional with any version of Python before 3.7. So you have to have 3.7 or above in order for any of this to work. So that pip3 install MinIO gives us all the details that we need, and now we're ready to go. So we're gonna open up a text editor. We're gonna call this connection. I'm gonna use vi, connect.py is gonna be the name of my file. And the first thing I need to do here is I need to import MinIO from the MinIO library, the MinIO client. So import MinIO, that's it, easy enough. That's the only import I'm actually gonna need here. The MinIO constructor can take a number of different flags. But here in our dev environment, we really just need the endpoint, the access key, the secret key, and secure. Now, handily enough, endpoint, access key, and secret key are the first three arguments. So I could literally just do my endpoint, access key, secret key, and then a comma. And then I would need to do secure equals false because there's a number of other fields that go into that constructor between secret key and secure. This is all just basic Python stuff, but I'm going to go ahead and create a client here. And this client is going to be constructed like this, MinIO, endpoint equals localhost 9000. And then I need to have an access key. I'm just going to tab this in a little ways for readability. Same again for the secret key. Again, that's dev user, dev password. We set that up in the last lab. And the last piece I need is secure equals false. Now, I have secure equals false here because I'm not using any kind of certificate with my containerized version of this. Endpoint, access key, secret key, and secure equals false, and that's all we need to do. By the way, I can skip out all of these blah, blah, blah equals very easily. I'm going to do that. Now that you know what each of these means, we can do it that way. Still need secure equals false. We'll make sure I write that out so we don't lose it. But that's our connect.py file. Let's continue on. This is enough, by the way. This is sufficient. I can run this and it will function. As a matter of fact, let me go ahead and do that. The problem, of course, is that it's not doing anything. It connects. But I need it to do something. So we're going to add a little piece of code here to get it to do something. And we'll just have it list the buckets. It's very easy to do. Don't worry too much about this code at this point. List buckets is a fairly straightforward command when you think about it. And all I'm really doing here is saying, give me a list of all the buckets. And then I'm going to do a simple for loop. Print. And we'll just print the bucket name and the bucket creation date. There's other things we could print. That's just the easiest way to go. Very simple piece of code. Feel free to copy paste that from the lab instructions, by the way. I don't need you to know how to list buckets or write all that yourself. So now that I've got all of this and we're writing it out, our next step is basically just to do that Python connect py again, or Python connection py. The lab says save it as connection. And there we go. We get our response back. We get a dev folder and we get some details about the dev folder, basically the connection information. And that's it. What I have now proven is that my code is working. Okay. That connection piece that we've got is going to be reusable. As a matter of fact, in future labs, we're going to provide you that connection piece yourself. But again, see how very easy it was for us to connect in to our code, to our running MinIO environment, and get everything up and running. And that's everything. That's our lab. For those of you who stuck it out through the rest of this demonstration, thanks very much for sticking with me, and we'll see you in the next session.